hit the ball higher and straighter from the fairway, the sand, and the rough. Order the hybrid approach wedge, risk-free for only $99. Visit us at hwedge.com.
Mike's out for a two-day custom program, and it's a pretty good program through Advantage Golf. They've set up schools, they market it, they send it, they've selected instructors around the country, and it's all custom. So when I sit down with him, we had a pretty extensive interview to find out where his game's been, what he's done, what he wants to do. So what I want you to do is I want you to go through the little short pitching drill, hit a couple full swings with it, then go to a longer club. Try to feel like it's the same motion, it's just smaller.
First was an introduction, explaining who he was, how long he's been doing this, and used to play on the tour and things like that. Then starting off small with very small shots, no more than 5 to 10 yards, to change your swing and get consistent with it, versus going out to a range with the driver and just hammering it, seeing how far you can hit it.
This is a drill. Ball forward, but I want to see you turn and try to get the hands as far forward as you can without using your arms. He mentioned, you know, what his strengths and weaknesses are, that he can hit a good shot. He's very strong. He just needed to learn the motion for a golf swing, because it seems simple to people who are strong to don't move your body much and just use your arms. That seems easier. And they don't understand that you really need to get the pivot swinging your arms. When you take power off, we want to take it off in your wrists first, then your arms. Finally, you're left with just your pivot. It's sequentially more like throwing a ball than hitting a ball. And so you had to get a freer motion, a better motion going. And he struggled at it yesterday. Today was great. I think you've improved your wrist action. So you may be hitting this farther than you would off a level lie, just because you're more square through impact. We hit shots like he hit yesterday, and he might have gotten 1 out of 10 airborne, because his arms just wouldn't let go of control. And so it was a real challenge. But I'm just really happy with his performance today. Anytime you're on a side hill lie, uphill, downhill, below your feet, above your feet, you adjust. Step one is to stabilize your feet. Step two is adjust your posture to match the ground.
Today we've been doing different side hill lies, uphill lies, chipping, things that will lower your score versus, you know, trying to hit it as far as you can.
The thing I like about this, just so you know, the first thing I said is you got to swing slower on this swing. It works better for you, doesn't it?
Again, it's in your feel and your swing of your body. If you're not doing it right, the tools don't work either.
You've got to learn the basis, and you've got to learn the sequences and how to move. And if you're real wristy in the swing, you will be inconsistent. Now start it slow, real slow. There. Feel the stretch here. I want to see this, and then this leads.
He has different tools that he incorporates in the lessons, and they're good tools.
Boy, that's better. Now take it away slowly. That feels different, doesn't it? Okay, go ahead and just hit it. Feel the difference? So if you fold your right elbow, it's going inside. If you keep it straight, it'll go straighter back and more outside. So your misses, especially out of this real clumpy grass, come from folding the elbow and letting the club get inside. So trying to find a way, and I think this is the art of teaching, is there's a lot of ways I could teach Mike and students like him. I need to find what he can relate to, what he can understand. How can I get more harmony in his swing? How can I get his hips, shoulders, arms working together best? And what's the best way to talk to him? What's the best analogies to use? What's the best images to use? What are the best training aids to use? So it's all trying to find that way. I don't believe there's a perfect swing, but there are swings that will repeat, and they generally all have the whole body and arms working together better.
So it's simply a pivot, shoulders only, your hips move to allow freedom, but there's no arms or wrists. Your arms and wrists relaxed, and you just start forward and turn through.
I would recommend, if they want to get better at golf, that they take private lessons, one-on-one, like I've been doing with Mike, and if they could come to this facility, I'm sure they'd be extremely happy with them, as I am, and it's a beautiful facility. The course is beautiful, the clubhouse is beautiful, and Mike is an excellent teacher.